Well, hello everyone. This is Daphne Clark, and this is Cooking with doTerra Essential Oils. Welcome to Take Roots, the lifestyle edition. And I am so happy that I get to educate you and possibly introduce you to just the whole concept of cooking with essential oils. And just a little bit about myself. I am a diamond leader with doTerra, living in Calgary. Yes, I have a South African accent. And 25 years ago, I was really fortunate. I did a degree in nutrition and cooking, and things have now turned around or come around full circle. And now I get to educate on essential oils. And so when I first was introduced to oils 2 years ago, I actually had no clue that they could be used for cooking. And as soon as I realized that oils could be, I went like, oh my goodness, yes, they are plant-based. And out with the herbs and in with the oils. And so, you know, I jokingly tell people, yes, I studied nutrition. I studied cooking. I actually studied to be a home economics teacher. I studied back when everyone thought that margarine was the healthy thing and that butter was not healthy. And you know that so much has changed since then. So my plan for this time with you is to really just introduce you to how you can use oils in cooking. And to share some tips with you, things that I've learned along the way. This is just a basic introduction, hopefully getting you to the place where you're excited about actually experimenting with oils in your baking and your cooking, and seeing how you can actually do away with your herbs and spices, and that you actually have such a gift in these little bottles of oils. So let's get your pen and paper out and let's get going. So cooking with doTERRA essential oils. Here I have some of my favorite in this picture. So we have lime and cilantro, black pepper and rosemary. And out of the 300 plants that we can get essential oils from, there's only about 75% of doTERRA oils that can be taken internally. So one of the things I do want to address, because I know it is a concern for some people when they first introduced to essential oils, is, are they safe to use? And believe it or not, many people think that it's a really new thing that we are using oils for cooking, but oils have actually or can be found in so many different types of foods. So yes, the first thing that I want to just look at, are essential oils safe to ingest? And that is a question I had when I first started my oil journey. Yes, my first oil that was actually ever introduced to me was around 5 years ago. I was given oil of oregano. And I did take that internally, but I soon found that that oil was really diluted. But when moving to Calgary, I went after trying to find a place that I could get lemon oil. And I headed off to the health food store, and I was told at the health food store, when she found out, the particular lady helping me, that I wanted to use lemon in my water, she said, no, you cannot. It is not an oil that is safe. And that's where I realized that there are different gradings of oils. So this is where doTERRA oils come in. And yes, you can safely use oils internally. They just need to be a pure and graded form of oils, just like doTERRA is. So let's just look at a few things that I thought I would show you. Now, I know these aren't very clear, but I wanted to show you that for a long while, we've actually been using essential oils, or we use products that have essential oils. And so here is the label of an ice cream container. And there circled is oil of peppermint. You know, so when people say, oh, I don't know if we should be taking oils internally, many of the products that we do eat will have essential oils in them. They will be a food grade of essential oils. But yes, we're still using oils. So there's an ice cream as an example. Here's peppermint patties, oil of peppermint, also not very very clear. So the surprising truth is that it is safe for us to use essential oils. And then I think went and I grabbed this lemon juice from my fridge, because here is lemon juice. We South Africans use it a lot in pancakes, but you will notice that there is lemon oil right over here. I didn't get to circle that, but a lemon oil has been used, not just the lemon juice, but the actual lemon oil is used in the making of this lemon juice. Okay. But we have for many, many years been using the food industry has been using essential oils in making chewing gum, candy, chocolate, and a lot more. And so we do one thing just establish is that there is a difference between cooking oils versus essential oils. Okay, so here we have some of the vegetable oils. Many of these you'll be familiar with. We have avocado oil. I use a lot of grapeseed in my home. Also use a lot of olive oil. There is canola. Now, what is the difference between these oils and essential oils? Well, vegetable oils contain glycerol, which we know is very greasy, and it leaves a residue and actually creates a slippery surface, you know, on our frying pan. So that's why we put it in a pan and it'll create that greasy surface. Now, essential oils do not, you know, you can put an essential oil in a pan and it's not going to create a greasy surface, okay? Vegetable oils, like these that are shown in this image, are 100% fat, where essential oils contain no fat at all. You know, when you put lavender oil on a pillowcase, many go like, oh, is it going to stay in the pillowcase? Well, no, it's not fatty or greasy, so it will not do that, okay? So vegetable oils are also primarily pressed from seeds and nuts like avocados and olives, or even the bran of some grains. But pure essential oils are steam distilled from plants, with the exception of your citrus oils, which come from, actually, they're not steam distilled. Citrus oils are cold pressed. Okay, so that's the primary difference. When we look at essential oils here, I've got just listed a few of those that I love to use. And this just brings me to basically to say one of the oils that I absolutely love in cooking is peppermint. And at the end of this session, I am going to share my ultimate favorite recipe with you that our family makes every single day. And I know you're going to fall in love with it. So healthy. So we're going to look at some these particular oils, how to use them in cooking. I do want to establish at the beginning that we really need to be careful when we come to cooking with essential oils, that we're not just heading off to any store and picking up an oil and putting it into our food. It needs to be a quality of oils that is safe for us to use, okay? So doTERRA, as many of us know, has a grading called CPTG, Certified Pure Therapeutic Grade. And this means that every single liter of essential oil is graded and is safe, okay? Now, as I said earlier, not every single oil is going to be used in cooking. Not every single essential oil from doTERRA is going to be taken internally. They don't need to be. About 75% of the oils can be taken internally. But this diagram just shows grapefruit. Here's an image of grapefruit. Now, the oil doesn't come from the juice. It actually comes from the rind. But it shows how this grapefruit has gone through different testings to ensure that by the time we finally get this little beautiful bottle of oil, that it is safe for us to use and to take internally. Okay, so let's look at some of the oils. And these are just a list of some of the oils that we can use. Remember, they are all plant-based. And that was the intriguing thing to me when I realized, oh yes, these are plants. Of course, we can use these in cooking. As a South African, this is said as oregano here in Canada or North America. In South Africa, we say oregano. But basically looking at quite a variety of oils that can be used in cooking and in baking. Okay. So essential oils are 50 to 70 times more potent than herbs. And here we have an image with some wonderful herbs and spices. There's anise, there's some turmeric over there, coriander. I think this is thyme that's in the container. These are herbs that you're going to have in your kitchen. You're either going to have them as a fresh form or you're going to have them dried, okay? But when you take an essential oil, it is so much more powerful. And that is one of the things that we need to establish. How do we take a recipe that does not have essential oils, that uses normal herbs and spices, and actually exchange it for essential oils? Well, the one thing we need to remember is that there are approximately 60 drops of essential oils in every teaspoon of oil, okay? And so you don't want to be taking a teaspoon of oil and just putting it into your food. If you look at this image, this is our peppermint, and we know that one drop of peppermint essential oil is equivalent to 28 cups of peppermint tea. So the oils are really, really potent, are really, really pure, and very, very strong. So we need to be careful with how much we add to our cooking, okay? So here are some tips when we're cooking with essential oils. Here you can see you've got your peppermint, you've got some lavender, that's your basil. Oh, I absolutely love basil. Make a wonderful salad dressing with it. But just as a tip, around one tablespoon of dried herbs is equivalent to a half to one drop of doTERRA essential oils, okay? So if you can't remember that in the beginning, just write it somewhere, put it on the fridge so that you know that if a recipe calls for a tablespoon of dried herbs, that you can use a half to one drop of doTERRA essential oils, okay? Very important tip for you is this is what I've learned through experience, is do not take the oil and just tip it over into your food, and because you'll never just get one drop. Rather, take a teaspoon, put a drop into the teaspoon, and then if needs be, you're going to use a toothpick. Okay, so you can substitute the essential oils in recipes that call for dried herbs, spices, or even your fruit juices. Okay, or if a recipe requires the zest of a lemon or an orange, you can also use those oils. So I'm going to go through five tips that have really helped me in my oil journey with cooking. And the first tip is get that toothpick out, okay? Because oils are so pure, you will want to use a toothpick at times to take, dip your toothpick into the bottle if you need to use that less than one drop, okay? So always start off using a half a drop to a single drop in dishes, because you can rather keep adding. But you can spoil a dish, particularly if you take a bottle of ginger and you add it to a stir fry and you just, you know, two or three drops, that is going to be too powerful. Some oils like oregano, you need to use a toothpick, or your hot oils like cinnamon, okay? Another tip is really make sure that the containers that you use for cooking are stainless steel or ceramic, okay, or glass. You don't want to be using plastic, because many of the citrus oils will break down the plastic, and that will be unhealthy for you. All right, tip number two. So when using doTERRA essential oils in place of the zest of one lemon or an orange or a tangerine, you can use 8 to 14 drops of its companion essential oil. For example, if the recipe calls for a zest of one lemon, grab your lemon oil and use 8 to 14 drops of its a companion essential oil. So that's your wild orange. I use it in smoothies in our home. All right, let's move on. So oregano, for sure you need to use the toothpick method, okay? So tip number three. So your cinnamon bark oil, your clove oil, your ginger oil, and oregano, because these doTERRA oils are so much stronger than the accompanying spices or herbs, okay? So with oregano, if you're going to put it into any Italian food that you're cooking, you need to get that toothpick out and be using it that way. Tip number four, because essential oils are volatile and because they also are destroyed by heat. Now, that was one question I had in the beginning, was how do you use oils in cooking and still maintain the therapeutic benefits? Well, some of the oils, the therapeutic benefit is going to be destroyed by the heat. But the best is to add that essential oil right before you're serving, okay? In this way, the heat will evaporate less. But there are times that you need to actually, with like basil and oregano and rosemary, you want to simmer these oils for a while to really enhance the flavor. So you're just going to have to experiment and see how things work for you. First, starting off with how much oil you put in, and then for how long you want those oils to actually be in your products or your food. Tip number five is keep your essential oil in the dark. Okay, and here is an awesome picture of just really being organized with your oils. They are put into dark bottles on purpose because your herbs and spices are not going to last forever, but oils, if they are kept in a cool, dark place, will last indefinitely, okay? Yes, you can refrigerate your essential oils. In this image, you also see little droppers. So I do keep droppers close by because it is so much easier to take a drop of oil out if you're wanting to really just regulate how much oil to put into your meal. And then keep the lids on to stop evaporation, because we know the heat around a stove. Oh, and then when you're so busy cooking, you can often push, maybe an oil is going to fall on the ground. If you are cooking with children, please, please, please be careful, okay? Make sure you get those lids back on again, because these are are great. I mean, it's awesome to cook with kids, but you just want to make sure that there's safety involved. And then just some suggestions for cooking. So salad dressings. So I love to take, this week I was actually making salad dressings just with balsamic vinegar, olive oil, and taking some lemon oil. You can take coriander, tastes so amazing. Then meats and sauces, your basil, your marjoram. Desserts, make a cheesecake with lemon. It's so lovely. Anything chocolatey, add peppermint to. When you come to making your teas, you know, just add a few drops of an oil or a combination of oil to a cup of tea, okay? Refreshing drinks, making your own lemon or peppermints can be added to cold or sparkling waters. I love to take, you know, I have a soda stream maker and you just make your own fizzy water and then go and add citrus bliss. Flavored honey, adding cinnamon, clove, lavender, basil, or chamomile. Warm the honey until it becomes a thin liquid, then add the oil. Then you've got everything Italian. So, you know, your oregano, your marjoram, your thyme, your basil. Those are really great for your pizza or pasta dishes. Then for those of us who love the Asian flair, try a drop of lemongrass or cilantro, coriander or ginger to enhance your Thai curries, your soups, or your stir fries. And then, oh, everything chocolate is peppermints for sure. So when you first start with doTERRA, you're always wondering, like, well, where do I get these recipes? Well, doTERRA have a blog, okay, the doTERRA recipe blog, and there's the link to it. And these recipes are submitted by doTERRA fans and then are tested. So here you've got a key lime pie. Here is a wonderful carrot and ginger soup. At the top is a stir fry made with orange and ginger oil. And it's endless. I mean, get online, go to the blog, try their recipes, and then you can actually put up your own recipes. So I've really found that a really useful link. One of the recipes our family loves is making our own chai tea. So I thought I would share this with you. You know, getting some cardamom, cinnamon, black pepper, wild orange, 2 tea bags, some water. And then, you know, you get, if you want to make it dairy-free, use some almond milk. And, you know, blend them all together and you have a wonderful chai tea with essential oils. So I wanted to share with you my peppermint milkshake. This is our family's all-time favorite. And I need to thank the author of the Oh She Glows cookbook when I was introduced to this by a close friend, Kimberly Malusis. And really, it is what I make every single morning for breakfast. It is healthy because I am dairy-free. And my kids love it. So you need to get your Vitamix out. I put the recipe here for you. It is indulgence, you know. So yes, the calories are high, but it's healthy. So medjool dates, almond milk, a handful of cashews, half an avocado. So your avo is a really great fat. Your cashews are really great for your skin. You know, a drop of peppermints. Now, there are times I would put 2 drops in, but I love the flavor of peppermint, but it's up to you. 5 ice cubes, a tablespoon of cocoa powder, and you blend. Now, you do need a strong blender. You know, a little magic mullet is not going to help to get those medjool dates. So that is just a tip for making a really healthy milkshake in the morning. And there we are, everybody. I hope you enjoy that. Go after learning how to use essential oils. It is a fun journey and you can get so much pleasure from cooking. Thank you. Bye-bye.